Hello everyone, I'm Garrick.
And I'm Thorpe.
And this is Primetime's virtual youth-led service.
We all hope that everyone is staying safe and healthy during this confusing and chaotic time.
As a group, we decided that our mission statement this year should be centered around persevering through this pandemic and staying connected through our faith.
Primetime's mission statement this year is, connected in love and spirit, we wait together. This is reflecting how we will be carrying out our stewardship this year.
We may not be able to see one another, but we can still embrace each other through our spiritual connection and through our faith.
Hi, my name is Camden Fry, and I will be praying the opening prayer. Loving God, even as we are physically distant from one another, we are united in your love. We gather for worship in our homes, missing the community of our church, but yet still we gather under the shelter of your wings. Even in this time of coronavirus crisis, we are still nurtured by your love and encouraged to fly by faith on the wind of your spirit. If we are ill, we pray for healing. If we are tired, we pray for strength. If we are anxious, we pray that you will help us consider the lilies of the field and the birds of the air. Don't let fear cause us to overlook the needs of others most vulnerable than ourselves, and help us to fix our eyes on your story and on our hearts on your grace. Help us always to hold fast to the good, see the good in the others, and remember there is just one world, one hope, and one everlasting love. Teach us to wait on you so that we may learn to fly, and strengthen us with the assurance that we do not fly alone. Prepare our hearts for a time of worship. This we pray in Jesus' name, in whom we trust these days and all days. Amen.
My name is Emilia Porter, and I will be reading to you the opening scripture. During this pandemic crisis, there is a lot of waiting. We wait for the virus to subside, for the curve to flatten. We wait for healing to happen. We wait for our school districts to provide us with year-end decisions. We wait for our health experts and government officials to give us the clearance to leave our homes and return back to normal. And during all this, we have waited for spring to come. So we wait, sometimes with fear, sometimes with anxiety, sometimes in loneliness. When you look at all that's going on, it's easy to think that somehow God doesn't notice or doesn't care. But in that face of this crisis, the prophet Isaiah reminds us that wherever we are, whatever our circumstances, God is always there. We are invited to wait with confidence, knowing that God is surrounding us with strength. Please hear these words from the prophet Isaiah.
Hi, I'm Kelly Kopecki.
And I'm Connor Stoff. And we're going to be reading
the message, Isaiah 40, verses 27 through 31. Why would you ever complain, O God, or whine? Israel saying, God has lost track of me. He doesn't care what happens to me. Don't you know anything? Haven't you been listening? God doesn't come and go. God lasts. He's creator of all you can see or imagine.
He doesn't get tired out, doesn't pause to catch his breath, and he knows everything inside and out. He energizes those who get tired, gives fresh strength to drops out. For even young people, tired and drop out. Young folks in their prime stumble and fall, but those who wait upon God get fresh strength. They spread their wings and soar like eagles. They run and don't get tired. They walk and don't lag behind. Thank you.
May God add a special blessing to our understanding of this word. Amen.
I'm Josie Hintz. Our gospel reading today reminds us that God will take care of us, especially during difficult times. We are encouraged to put our energy and our time into that which gives meaning to life, relationships, kindness, service, discipleship. We are children of God, and we are invited to rest in that knowledge. God will help us with the struggles we face. Please hear these words from the Gospel of Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
I'm Christopher Carbash, and I'll be reading Matthew 6, 30 through 34 from the Message. If God gives such attention to the appearance of wildflowers, most of which are never seen, don't you think he'll attend to you, take pride in you, do his best for you? What I'm trying to do here is to get you to relax, not to be so preoccupied with getting so you can respond to God's giving. People who don't know God and the way he works fuss over the things, but you know both God and how he works. Steep in your life, God, reality, God, intentively, God, provisions. Don't worry about missing out. You'll find all your everyday human concerns will be met. Give your entire attention to God is doing right now. And don't get worked up about what may or may not happen tomorrow. God will help you deal with whatever hard things come up and when the times come. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Hello, my name is Ethan Dugan. During this time of waiting, we can still worship, serve, and remain connected to one another and God. We can remain hopeful, patient, and faithful. We can take this time to reflect on what is important and focus our time and energy on the things that matter the most. Unfortunately, COVID-19 has forced us to cancel many things, including the 2020 mission trip to Blackfeet Nation in Montana. But it's also forced us into time of waiting and reflection. We are looking forward to serving and doing mission work locally as soon as it is safe, but for now we wait. Yeah, while we are waiting, we will, as the lyrics to the next song state, move ahead, being bold and confident, and knowing that we are not waiting alone. We wait together. This is how we wait.
While I'm waiting, I will not fail. Good morning. It's Pastor Susan. I invite us to be in a time of prayer. Let us pray. God, we thank you for the youth of our church who have come together to offer their best in serving you, in worshiping you, and in leading us into a future of hope. In these extraordinary times, we confess our sadness and our fears. We are especially sad for our youth as the primetime mission trip to Montana has been canceled. But we thank you for the many ways that our youth continue to serve you and love others. We ourselves feel stuck, overwhelmed, helpless, and maybe even hopeless. Help us, God, to believe that the present does not control our future. Inspire and sustain us to carry on, offering what we can in service to you and our neighbors. We pray for those who are infected with the coronavirus and pray that you will take away any fear, anxiety, and feelings of isolation they might be experiencing. Protect their families and friends and bring peace to all who love them. We pray for those fighting on the front lines of this pandemic, our first responders, nurses, doctors, and other healthcare professionals, to save as many lives as they can. Shelter them from this virus and grant your healing mercies to those who will get sick despite their best efforts to protect themselves. We pray for medical equipment and personal protection equipment to be made available. And we pray that you can help us to do the most important thing we can to protect others and lessen the severity of the strain on the medical system, and that is to just stay home. It is with heavy hearts that we lift in prayer the people of Nova Scotia and for all of Canada as they grieve senseless death, 23 victims in all in the country's deadliest mass shooting. May you surround our Canadian brothers and sisters with your healing love and peace. And in support and in gratitude of Earth Day, we pray that we can always walk gently upon this earth, taking only what we need, giving back to the earth in gratitude. And may we honor all of your creation with reverence, mindful of those who come after us, and recognizing our proper place as part of, not apart from, your creation. And we pray together the prayer taught to us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Oh, God of life, God of hope, God of all, lift us on your love like eagle's wings. Sustain us, guide us, strengthen us, heal us. Then send us forth into the world that we may love as you love. Go in peace, people, God, and let us be loved to one another.